Good morning.
Good morning.
Our church describes our mission with four key elements. Today, let's think about the second concerning discipleship. It says, growth in individual Christian discipleship through work and study. What does it mean to be a Christian disciple? In the church where I grew up, there were pictures on the walls showing Jesus and his disciples wearing robes and sandals. In describing the early church, the book of Acts, chapter 2, tells us what Christ's followers did. The believers studied what the apostles taught. They were students. But the word disciples means follower. More than looking like a disciple and more than studying, Christianity, it actually is the following of the path of Christ. Jesus told his disciples, feed the hungry, give drink to the thirsty, welcome the stranger, clothe the naked, care for the sick, visit those in prison. The disciples shared their lives together. They ate and prayed together. They sold property and other things they owned. They gave to anyone who needed something. So how does this congregation grow in discipleship? We study the Bible, what the Bible teaches, through the leadership of our pastor, Bible study groups, sacred music, retreats, devotional studies such as the Upper Room, and programs and resources of our association, our conference, and the United Church of Christ. Our children and youth learn about our faith in Sunday school, confirmation class, church camp, and youth events. But to become disciples of Christ, we must be more than students. We must be followers of Christ. Members have donated food, clothing, and financial assistance for needy local families and for areas in crisis around the country and around the world. We've supported our community by sharing our church building with local nonprofit groups, conducted mental health first aid training, and hosted interdenominational worship with Middlebury's faith community. Our Vacation Bible School has served children of both members and guests. Our youth have participated in service projects locally and thousands of miles away at the Cheyenne River Sioux Reservation in North Dakota. Pastor Katrina, along with Lexi Peltzar and Julia Belmont, traveled to South Korea to meet members of our partner churches there, worship together, exchange ideas, and learn more about each other's cultures. Since the early days of our church, we have raised up ministers who carried the gospel to communities, churches, and colleges far from Middlebury and to our armed forces. Last night, I printed this week's crier. And as I was looking it over, I quickly spotted the many ways that we practice discipleship every week. I circled them in red. I know you can't see it from a distance, but when you go home, take a look. There's hardly an item in there that doesn't represent our discipleship. We've truly been disciples of Christ, but we need to do more and do it often. It takes time, talent, and treasure, sometimes a little, sometimes more. Are you ready to put on your discipleship sandals? I brought mine. So today, when you see me with my comfy discipleship sandals, think about how you're going to do that. Fortunately, as the psalmist said, we are wonderfully made, blessed with great ideas, creative thinking, leadership skills, sensitivity, teaching, cooking, coaching, mentoring, music, theatrical, renovation, and technical talents, altruistic and friendly outlooks, and generosity. As our church makes plans for the coming year, what will you contribute of your time, talent, and treasure to help us become the best disciples we can be?